So it started out like back in 9th or 8th grade. So there was this dirt rally game over there. So I was thinking, why are there not any similar kind of games in the similar concept like in any mobile? I took a pen and pencil, simple as that, like how every game designer does. I write out a few notes and everything, how the game goes about, what the game is. So my sketching was pretty bad at that time. So I used to make like some rough sketches of how it's gonna look and everything. So from there, I started my own like designing kind of video games and everything, just putting them on a piece of paper and writing down the mechanics, and that's it. So that's how it started. And then now I make like, I do all of that stuff for my company, where I make 5 to 6 game designs every single day. I'm the founder of Origami Games, and I founded this company in September 2020. That was 2 or 3 months after I completed my work and job experience and everything. So I started the company out with just me. So I was handling, I was making GDDs, I was completely making like 15 to 20 games in a week or something. I had all these ready and I filled the entire diary of 100 pages. After that, I started hiring out people, and now we are a team of 30 people, where 6 of us work in the office. The rest, everyone is working all over India, be it Punjab, Delhi and Chennai and all. So we all have a Zoom call or something in the morning to discuss what the agenda for the day is and everything. And we are planning opening a bigger office in Mumbai itself, and then getting a lot of people funding it so that more people can work on more games and making India like hyper-casual games famous in India. When Ecole Individual Lab, the college, got over first year in Feb something. So after that, I was searching on Google for some work from home internships where I can just learn something new and make some money out of it as well. So I got this company, it's called as CBS Games. It's in Mumbai itself, and so they had a hyper-casual gaming studio and everything. I got this internship because I had to research through what hyper-casual games are. So the question was, what are hyper-casual games? And that's the first question he gave me for the interview round and all. So I explained him everything and all. So his game was like the one of the few, his company is actually one of the few that came in the beginning from India like to publish in hyper-casual games and all. And then I got the internship, I worked for a month. I got to know the basics of what the mechanics are, how do you go about it, how do you make them in Unity and all. Then 2 months back, I'm still just bored because of the lockdown and everything. I'm just still wondering what to do. I get another internship at Stareout Games. So my internship was just 2 months over Stareout Games. After that, I was working over there as a game designer, where my daily job was to make at least 15 to 20 games in a day. So over there, I got to know a little bit about Unity, a little bit about Blender, how the models and everything is created. But my main part was to think about the mechanics and everything. So over there, I was offered around $2,000 to $3,000 per game that gets published in the market. 4 months into that, I was just wondering like, why is this guy offering me just $3,000 just for an internship and just for a single idea that I'm writing on a piece of paper? So I did my research, I saw how much money this hyper-casual market has, and why I still don't know why Indians haven't explored it. I mean, there's only one or two companies which are doing proper hyper-casual games in India. So that's when I thought that this can be something which I can do, because whatever hyper-casual games are, they can be done in 3 days. Any hyper-casual game can be made in 3 days. You just need a day to make the design and everything. Second day for the artist to make the materials and all the assets and all. Third day, you just integrate them, you get the video for 15 to 60 seconds, and then you just test it out on the market. So the fourth day, when you're testing out the games on the market, if the test scores are good, you just make 100 levels of that game, and the game goes into publishing and all. And then you make a good amount of money for that. So the hyper-casual game that we have developed it, It's going to go in testing phase, and mostly it's going to be good enough because we have already got a heads up by the publisher. So we are publishing it with Zplay. It's a company in Hong Kong, and so it's more about assassinating people. So it's a fun to play game. It's not just all bloodshed and everything. There's no bloodshed because it's a hyper-casual game. It has to be simple, children can play and everything. So it's about jumping over the buildings, doing parkour, being in the stealth mode and everything. So it's more of a ultra casual kind of a game where we don't focus on the environment or anything, we just focus on the mechanic. First year of Ecole in PeteLab, we have these two lectures. It's called as non-digital gaming, and the other lecture was creativity. So creativity, what our teacher used to make us do was, she used to show a movie or a trailer, and she used to ask to make, like, think about some 10 or 15 game ideas you can from that trailer in a span of 2 days. So that is something which is still helping me today, because that's what I do in my company. I just take a random YouTube video and I make 10 to 15 games out of it, and then we just go and test it out. Secondly, for non-digital gaming, we used to play many kind of board games and all, which were, some of which were not there in the market also, so I used to get them for us. So you get to know a lot about the mechanics, the gameplay, and some, these two lectures really helped me out in the first year. When it comes to the second year, we have Unity, we have Blender, like the artwork, this thing, and we also have designing. So game designing helped us with mechanics and everything, the 2D artwork, the 3D artwork, that helped us with the, like, it helped me personally, because I now know everything about, like, all the sides. If I want to ask my interns, like, what are you doing today in Unity, so I know about the code, I know about how Unity works, I know how the game is going to get designed, how the GDD is going to look and everything, and that's all because of Eco Intuit Lab.